And I think I murdered my grandmother.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Congratulations. You've stumbled upon my tape, where I'm certain I'll be 6 feet by now. Here's the truth. I snuffed out my wife, Ethel Myrtle, with my own hands. Craftily, I pinned the whole sordid affair on my feeble grandson. Oh, Tommy boy, you were a breeze to deceive. My hands may be dirty, but yours will bear the weight of the blame. You see, when you've got one soul dependent on meds to numb the pain, and another reveling in them for twisted delight, pitting them against each other is child's play. Just drop the pills next to the addict's pitiful bedside. I waltz in, the virtuous savior. Tom and I indulge in a deceitful game of poker, and as he rises to use the head, I sneak a generous dose of sleeping pills into his tea. Sweet dreams, Tom, you gullible pawn. Once Ethel was dealt with, I moved his body into her quarters. When he comes to, I'm sure he'll believe the terrors of the war made him do such a terrible thing. He won't suspect it was me. Little does he know, I had him dancing to my malicious tune. I've got him fooled. I fed him a load of lies, making him believe I'm off on some extended work trip tonight. I'd kill him too, but unfortunately, he's my cover. Here's the motive. I've gambled my life for this damn country. Yet, who gets the accolades? Not me, but Ethel. Maybe once I erase her from the scene, they'll finally acknowledge the greatness I've achieved, the masterpieces I've crafted. And if they still don't, well, this confession will cement me as the legend who silenced the renowned author Ethel Myrtle and got away with it.